Let's take group three now.
Hello, sir. Prashant
Hello.
from Group 3.
Yes. Very good afternoon.
Formed this set of questions taking inputs from Dr. Narayan Marathe and Professor Harish.
Very good.
The other two members, we have not heard from them, sir.
Okay.
The question paper, we thought we will make it for 20 marks. And
Okay.
some questions I have given, some questions the other two have given. So like that, this is how we have made the
Very
question
nice.
paper. The idea is that since the week 1 to 8 is distributed, all the lectures are distributed. So when we frame questions from this, so we will have importance given to each of the components of week 1 to 8. So this is how we did. And these are some of the questions that are there. Some questions are like derivation type of thing, and some questions are numerical examples and others also. So with that,
Now, let's go to the first question. Let's go to the first question here. Derive the following for now. What does it mean? Now, when you say derive the following for an SI system, step function in terms of impulse function has nothing to do with LSI systems.
Hari, just a minute. Harish is there.
Step function and impulse function, the step function and the impulse function are independent of any system.
Whether it is LSI or any other system,
No,
they
there's
are.
no system. There are two functions. So why should the system come in here?
Similarly, the other two also, impulse function in terms of step and
Yeah.
then. So
However,
it's.
no, but no, but for the third one, impulse response in
Response.
terms of step response, yes, there it's a system which is involved. No? So, the impulse response of an LSI system, otherwise this question doesn't make sense.
So
So,
and
you have to be
the
careful when you're framing the question. There is this is this, the first two parts have nothing to do with systems. Right?
Can we reframe it as derive the relations for?
Huh. So you could have two parts in the question. The first part, you ask the relation between the step function and impulse, whatever generalized function, the step input, step and the impulse. And in the third part, you ask a relation between the step response and impulse response, and make it clear whether you want the impulse response to be written in terms of step response or step response to be written in terms of impulse response. So, there you have to be your so the framing has to be much more precise. Good. All right. Let's go to the next question.
This we thought investigate the causality and stability of
This
the
is okay.
following.
This is fine because here, that's a well-framed question. So, it's very clear what has to be done. You have to say whether that, and you investigate the cause. So, in fact, if you want to make it even more precise, you could say, investigate whether the following systems are causal and stable, explaining your reasoning clearly. Otherwise, it's okay. I mean, the question is well framed. Okay.
And week 7 and 8 were given by Professor Narayan Marathe. So
Okay.
given
Professor Marathe,
given
is he here?
maybe he said he is having some difficulty in connecting, sir. So he
Okay.
is in transit. He has texted. We have a WhatsApp group over which we are communicating.
Okay. Doesn't
So
matter. So fine. So you could explain. Give an example of a discrete system which is marginally stable. Okay. Fine, but you must accept many different answers here.
so the student will be so you will get varieties of answer and
Yeah.
the
So you have to get, you have to be willing to evaluate many different kinds of answers.
yes.
Comment on the convolution of the following signals with themselves. Huh? That is, comment on means what kind of a comment do you want? When you say comment on, see the now when you say comment on, see you have to be careful. There are some very naughty students. comment on the convolution. The student will comment saying that this is question is too difficult for me, and you have to give him full marks.
Full marks, yeah, correct. Correct.
If you say comment on the convolution, what comment are you expecting? If you say comment, and if the student says this question is too difficult, you have to give him full marks, no? He's commented. Maybe, these students are sometimes very naughty. So you have to say, you know, obtain. Either you say obtain the convolution of the following signals with themselves.
Okay. Isn't it? Obtain the convolution.
Yes.
Like unit impulse with unit impulse. Okay, sir.
Yes.
But will that be too much for 3 marks? Maybe.
Yes. Are you saying all these five? It's rather ambitious.
Or maybe any two, like we can say.
Yeah, any two is that. Any two. Yeah. Of course, then the student may choose the easiest. See, when you say any two, then again, then you know, they should be of similar difficulty. Now, see, for example, unit step with itself is trivial.
Trivial, yeah.
Sorry, unit impulse with itself is trivial. Sorry, but unit triangular with triangular with triangular is very, you know, is a fairly complicated convolution. So why would the student choose triangular with chi? He would choose unit impulse, isn't it?
So no one will see 3 onwards, no one will see.
Nobody, no, if you said any 2, then they'll take the first 2.
Okay.
But of course, the student should know what convolution means, then he will choose the first 2. But then everybody will choose the first 2. Any intelligent student will choose the first 2, isn't it? Why would he choose the last 3? Of course, if you're trying to test that, then it's fine.
Okay.
If you're trying to test that, you know, the student knows that convolving itself with itself is easy for the first 2, and it's all right.
Okay. So that portion we'll have to. Especially, sir, when we are setting up the question papers for yes. our internal question in our
yes.
College, so there we will not have this kind of difficulty. Reason is we have some fixed marks and we can think of. But over here, we all
no,
thought.
But professor. Tell me, suppose you set this question in your internal exam.
Yeah.
Comment on the convolution. Would it be acceptable?
It's obviously not. Yeah.
Yeah. In your internal exam, the students would have the same problem, no?
Yes. Yes. Correct. Yeah. And the second part is again similar for the discrete domain. So that one.
Yeah.
And we made some assignment questions.
Very good. Yes. Let's see those.
For define the following with an example for each. So
yes.
signal a system, a description of a system is there. So I yeah. think there we are. Explain the following properties of system. So we'll have to
see normal. Yeah, this is okay. Then assignment, it's all right. Okay, so these are more like review assignments, I would think. No.
Okay.
So this is your third one is good. See, this, in fact, first one also is good. Define the following with an example for each. That's a good example. That's a good question.
Okay, sir.
The third one also is nice. Illustrate with example when system loses.
Huh.
Very good. That's an example. That's a good, yeah. All right. Yeah.
So, we have made such some 20 questions.
These are review questions. No, good, good. Very nice. Or some questions which probe further whether the student has understood.
Some very causality good. Related.
Very good, very good. Well, I think this is well done. Good.
Thank you, sir.
Good. Very well attempted. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
All right. It's very good. Good.
All 3 members have contributed together and that
yes.
is the.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Very good. Very nice. Professor Marathe put up a comment in the chat. Anyway, we have resolved that issue.
Oh, he has joined. Yes.
Okay, very nice. So very good, very well done. So very good. I'm very happy to see the attempts that people made to frame question papers and assignments. And now I think, you know, it's almost time. I think we've come to the end of this course. So now we'll have a short, you know, we don't want to do a long valedictory or something. It's essentially just a short valedictory message which I wish to give. As you know, this course is the first among 2 workshops. This workshop rather, not course, this workshop is the first among 2 workshops. We are doing a workshop on E210.1x and also now in the coming weekend, we are doing a workshop on E210.2x. Now in this workshop, we took the first two aspects of a signal and systems course, namely signal and systems in the natural domain and signal systems in the Fourier domain. In the next workshop, we'll be taking the next two parts of a typical signal and systems course. We would look at, see now here we have looked at continuous and discrete separately. Is that right? So all through E210.1, you will notice that continuous and discrete were always treated separately. They were always treated as if continuous was a separate kind of system, discrete was a separate kind of system. In the first part of E210.2x, we would bring these together. How can you look at discrete systems that are equivalent to continuous systems? And therefore, we deal with the sampling theorem, sampling and reconstruction, and we introduce some basic principles of digital signal processing. In the last part, the second part of E210.2x, we would look at the generalized transforms, the Laplace transform and the Z transform. So that is advanced material, so to speak, right, in some sense. So I definitely look forward to many of you joining for the second course. It starts on the 4th of December and goes on to the 7th of December. The program is identical to this one. So we start on 4th evening. The only difference is that if there are common participants, they, of course, if there are new participants, then they would have to be welcomed and so on. If there are common participants, we can first, in the first session on the 4th, we could take a review of what we learned. So instead of, you know, people just introducing themselves, we would like, them to review what they learned from the first course, if there are common participants, and then go on to the material and then introduce themselves. Right? And then, of course, the other sessions will be identical. We would be looking at the content of the other second course and so on. So I look forward to many of you joining the second course. Now, a few points. I would like to invite our workshop team to tell you a little more about certain aspects of outreach and outlet. So I think Mahendra Parmar, is he going to be speaking today?
Hello, Professor Gadre, Kalpana here. So I will talk about it.
Yeah, yeah. So Dr. Kalpana will then talk to you about creative
coaching.
Yeah. In fact, you could take this occasion for any other input that you would like to give the participants.
We would like to give us short presentation. So please let us know when.
Let's have the presentation now. Let's have the presentation. Are you ready with the presentation?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so let's have
it. So, couple of announcements before I present.
Yes.
So,
yes.
One is that we have given the workshop feedback form. It is available on the IIT Bombay X Your Course page.
Yes.
And so it is at the end of the all the weeks. So it is the title is workshop feedback. So I request all of you to please fill the feedback form.
Yes.
And so you can do it either today or in another 2 days. And all the submissions, graded activity submissions, we have extended the last date till December 4th.
That's right.
So
feedback can be given up to 4th of December, is it fine?
Yeah, yeah.
So we make everything uniform. All the submissions, including the feedback, should come by 4th December.
Yeah, so everything, all the graded activities and feedback, please finish it before 4th December.
That's
so
right.
That after that, we will generate the certificate.
That's
and
right.
The certificate will be e-certificate, which will be available on your dashboard. And once the certificate is generated, you'll be able to see it on your dashboard. You can download it. It will be as a PDF file and you can save it. And there is also a verification link, so you can anybody who wants to verify the certificate, they can use the verification link to verify the certificate. So these are all the announcements which, and we also want to let you know that all the recordings of this workshop along with whatever material has been created by you will be released under open source under Creative Commons license CC BY SA. So that is by attribution and share alike. So this is an information which we want to let everybody know, that in case you have any objection, you have to let us know, but we will be releasing this all the content under Creative Commons license. And those who have registered through Lakshya website, I think at the time of registration itself, you would have clicked on that you agree to release the content by Creative Commons. But people who have come through TechCube, this was not incorporated in the registration. So therefore, you must have received an email from eOutreach. So please go through that Creative Commons license and fill it and send us back, so that we have that in our records, we have your consent to release the content. So that's all. And now I will like to give a short presentation about the courses, which will be available on IIT Bombay X, so that you can tell your students and other colleagues. So I'll present now. So I'm sure you all know about our program now. So we conduct many courses through IIT Bombay X, which is our MOOC platform. And usually the registration is open on the Lakshya portal, where you have to register and make the payment. Usually our course fee are very nominal. And during this pandemic, we know that everybody is going through a lot of difficulties. And they are also short of, there is also shortage of funds and students cannot afford. So we have made our courses at, we are charging very little. So in fact, this semester we had offered many courses, around 13 courses for students. And all those are available on our IIT Bombay X platform. If you want, you can go through it. And we have some very good pedagogy courses similar to this workshop. So the forthcoming pedagogy workshop for faculty on computer programming, the dates are not yet finalized, but that it will start soon. It will be sometime in December. And there will be also pedagogy workshop for teachers for how to teach in online mode. So teaching learning workshop. That will be sometime in January. And in February end, we will have a pedagogy workshop for the subject thermodynamics. So, and TechCube, this will also be through TechCube, jointly organized by TechCube. So all the faculty members who are part of the TechCube 3 Institute, you can tell your colleagues and you can also tell your coordinator so that you are, you can inform everybody. Then for students, how the students can benefit from our courses is because these courses are available. We are making it available in self-paced mode. So the whole course content is available for the students over for a period of 6 months. So they can learn anytime along with their college. This thing, it will not hamper their regular studies, and they can also gain knowledge by joining these courses. And the course, and it is at a very affordable price. We are making it available to students for less than 500 rupees. Most of our courses are for around 400 rupees or even less. So this is it is at a very affordable price. So you can tell your students about these courses, and the students will get a IIT Bombay X honor code certificate after they successfully complete the course. So the registration on IIT Bombay X and on Lakshya will start from around December 20th for the next semester. And we will start the courses from 15 January onwards, and it will be open till 30th April. So in this time period, they can, you know, finish their course, and it will be available to all the students. So the main areas are in computer science and in core engineering. So in engineering, we have signals and systems, thermodynamics, and in computer science, we have basic programming course, data structures, implementation of data structure. And in skill courses, we have courses on English, both written and oral. and we have soft skills, and we have workplace communication, and we also have LaTeX course under skill courses. So and we will be offering some more new courses, most probably in Python and DBMS and shell programming. So please tell your students and tell them to register. And if some institute are interested in bulk registration, we are also offering bulk registration. And for that, a separate link will be provided for registration. So in case your institute, if many people, like more than 100 people, want to join from your college, we will provide a bulk registration option also. And if any teacher wants to offer the course as a blended MOOC, we will register all the teachers free of cost. We will not be charging any money from the teachers. And you can use the course material from our courses, and you can supplement it with your own if required. And we also encourage some of you and your colleagues to act as a discussion forum moderators, so that you can not only help your own students, but students from other colleges also. And we will also provide a certificate for those who act as a discussion forum moderator. And you can, for bulk registration, we'll also be giving additional support, that we'll be providing a MIS portal where you can monitor the performance of your own students, and you can give some weightage for the online activity on the platform, and you can have your own assessment, and you can combine both for the final assessment. So marks obtained in IIT Bombay X courses can be used for internal assessment. So you can decide how much weightage you want to give, whether it is 20, 80, or 30, 70, that is up to you. So these are our contact details. So anytime you can contact us, and I hope you all enjoyed this workshop. And I also encourage all of you to register for the part two of Signals and Systems, so that you can benefit from the whole course. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, Dr. Kalpana. In fact, maybe can we put up this presentation in the 210.1 pedagogy course? That may be better. No?
We can all. Yeah. So we can also put this as a part of the resource.
Course material, because it's a straightforward presentation, so it can be a part.
Yes.
In fact, we made a part of all courses, perhaps, isn't it? So,
We can do that. So that is. If anybody has any questions or query, I can quickly answer.
So we'll take any questions that there are. So I think Professor Jayanti had a question, Professor Jayanti, but I think that has been clarified. She says, is the course material available only for 6 months? No, once you register.
So, so this is a good question. So I just want to tell you that once you register on IIT Bombay X, this course will be always be available on your dashboard. So you don't have to do anything. You don't have to download anything. It will be once you log in to your dashboard, it will be available. Only thing is, when we go for upgradation from one version to another, so for that time we will, when we migrate, that time for maybe 15 days or so, that time you will not be having access, but otherwise it will be available on your dashboard.
Sir, for the part two workshop, can the course be available online a little bit earlier so that we will get time to go through it?
Yes. In fact, I was just going to mention that. Yeah. So, you know, what we do is, Dr. Kalpana, can we arrange that all those who might have already registered
for So, we have. We can add you, and I think we will do it today itself.
Yeah,
so if you have already registered, we will add you to the course, and you can view the course content ahead of
time. Because that's more difficult also. That material is more difficult, and you know, you could, in fact, and it will be, the pattern will be identical, you know, so you could prepare for it beforehand. So those of just for our information, are there some confirmed people who are going to come for the second course in this?
There are very few. Right now, we have got only 7 registrations from. I think TechCube, maybe 17, 10 have come from Valchan and 7 from this thing. And the rest are on IIT Bombay Lakshya site. We have around 7.
Okay, fine.
So those of you who have not yet registered for part 2, the registration is open till Friday. So you can definitely register even now. And if those of you who are from TechCube, also
so you know, I mean, if we for part 2, I think we can immediately make the material available to those who have registered.
Yeah, those who have registered. Yeah, so we will add them today itself, so they can view the course.
That we, because you know that's more difficult material, and you know it'd be nice for them to see it right from now. You know,
yeah,
good. All right. So any other questions or any other? So now we open the floor. You know, we take a few minutes. We open the floor. Anybody who would like to say anything in conclusion? You know?
So Prashant here.
Yes.
I felt extremely elated and happy to be part of this particular workshop. Best thing that I have learned is your frequency selectivity nature. So what you have been doing is no matter what is the content of the presentations that we have made, you have always selected the best and amplified it and then transferred it to all the other participants. So that is what I am going to take first thing. Then subject wise, the pedagogical relations, so many things we have discussed. It has been a very good exposure. And sometimes whatever the mistake that I'm making, it was glaringly on my face again. So I felt that, you know, so I should not be making that. So I hope I'll be remembering all these things and I'll be incorporating these in my upcoming classes in the institute here at BMS IIT Bangalore. And all my colleagues, batchmates, group number 3 were extremely helpful in preparing all the contents timely, and due to my some personal commitments, I'll not be able to take up the next part, sir. Reason is some family commitment. So I'm going to miss that, but maybe if future, if we have some similar events, I'll be definitely joining that. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you everyone for all the support, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Prashant. We are very happy to have you in this course, and we were very happy to see your enthusiastic participation. You know, all through, I mean, you've sustained your participation right from the first day until the last.
Yes,
very creditable. I know that all of us are, you know, in these days extremely preoccupied by whether it is with domestic duties, including me, you know, with domestic duties and with professional duties and so on. So to have made time for this is also a matter of credit for each of the participants who has made time. And we really appreciate your enthusiastic participation. And yes, I mean, you know, it's we all need to carry away certain things from this workshop. And, you know, we would end. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
In fact, you know, for the TechWhip participants, we would encourage the TechWhip, because the TechWhip participants, you know, we are supporting them from the TechWhip kite. You know, we would encourage you to tell your other TechWhip friends to participate, you know.
Okay.
We'll try and offer. Do you think we should offer this workshop again with some modifications, perhaps? Not for you people, but for some other people.
Yes sir. You know, this you know, type of activities, especially for the newcomers, sir. You know, those who are just joining the varieties of institutes across India, I feel even if the these recordings are made available, also that is also a great service.
Recordings will be made available, but I thought we can also have it live, because see, that makes a difference. If you know, if we are interacting live, it makes a big difference.
Yes sir.
So that's true, made available as live for new people again.
Yeah.
So maybe after some time.
And in the feedback form, I have requested for the digital filter design or even the filter designs. So I have you know, the feedback form was asking if there are any future this one. So I have mentioned their digital filter design.
Well, you know, BMS, if I'm not, I have also announced a TechWhip course on digital signal processing, which I'm planning to offer in, you know, the next week. If you're interested, you could join that, you know, that is, if you're, but if you are, if you're not busy next week, 9th,
4th, 5th, 6th, and now there is one wedding happening. So.
No, that's fine. This is from 9th December.
Okay, sir. 9th. Yeah.
So on our PPPCCLT website, I'm planning, I'm actually thinking how to do it, but we are planning, you know, DSP workshop also. DSP
okay.
workshop on
DSP,
under in fact I'm going to so for I must mention to you under NPTEL my lectures we are creating a course on digital signal processing and all this will be discussed there.
Okay.
Filter design, you know, it's being created, it's almost in a final stage now.
Okay, sir. Yes.
Under NPTEL.
Okay, sir. Thanks.
Yeah. So any other participants would like to share?
In the present list it is not there.
Pardon me, madam.
The NBTL present list has recently come in.
No, present. Oh, no, it has been announced. No, it's not been announced. I thought it was announced. It's been announced for January.
Yeah. Okay.
In fact, I thought I'll ask Mrs. Bharati, but it has been announced. You know, I thought the course has been announced for January.
We received one mail, tentative list.
Oh, no.
I don't know whether this course is there. I haven't seen.
Which one? The BSP, digital signal processing? Yes, it should be there. If it is not, please let me know. Because see, the digital signal processing course is being offered in January. In the sense that, you know, it's starting the January semester, we are offering digital signal processing.
Okay, sir.
Please look up NPTEL.
Yeah.
Because Mrs. Bharati told me that it has been announced for January. That's why I said we are in the final stages of, you know, finalizing the course content in the coming week. And the course is to start from January.
Okay.
So therefore it must have been announced. I think it has been announced, I think. In fact, the registrations are open.
Yeah.
For that.
Yeah. Okay.
Please check. I think if not, please let me know because, you know, then it should be visible. She told me the registrations are open.
Yes.
So my digital signal processing course will come up in NPTEL. Yeah. So
yes, sir.
Yes, Professor Atre.
DSP course is open, sir. I registered for that.
Yes, that's what I thought because Professor Atre will tell you. Yeah, she.
Yes, sir. It's there. So it is seen in this one NPTEL list, Marathi.
Right, right. Correct.
The course is from 25th January. It is starting. 25th January. Yeah.
Because we are finalizing we are in the final stages of finalizing the content this week. So very nice. So would anybody else like to speak and share any thoughts? And very nice.
Sir, this is Meenakshi Atre.
Yes.
Again. Sir, because of this workshop, we got to know many pedagogical aspects as well as the interaction with you was very important and it's a great addition to our knowledge because even the minute details were discussed, not a single point you were tired and you were like fed up of the small doubts we had or the misclarifications that we did in our Google form as well that we designed today. So we are really happy and we got to know each other also. So purposefully your team made the groups which are outside Pune and we got to know the other people who are senior, who have teaching signals and systems many times. So we got so much to learn. And thank you so much. This live interaction made us really happy and more knowledgeable and others also who are very knowledgeable in the field of signals and systems. They also contributed a lot to increase our knowledge. So thank you so much once again, sir. Thank you, team. Thank you, all the participants. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Sir Satre. I think I must also appreciate your participation. You participate very actively and conscientiously right from the first day until the last. Very creditable indeed. As I said, you know, I know that all of us are quite overburdened with several kinds of commitments. And to, you know, to take out time,
yes,
and you know, it's and to do the assignment so sincerely is definitely a matter of great credit. Very nice.
Sir, in line with the Meenakshi, I would like to really appreciate your energy level, sir.
Oh, thank you. So nice.
In the evening, even on Sunday, you had the same energy level what you had in the morning, which is really appreciable, sir.
Yes.
You took.
Thank you so much. Comments. Nice to hear.
Very
thank
nice, you. Sir. Very. It was a very nice experience for all of us.
Thank you.
Even as a teachers, we get we get irritated if same question is asked or some mistake goes on. But sir was handling all the questions very patiently and lovingly. There was no single point that sir was tired and he was fed up. Thank you.
I'll share with you the previous semester. I was teaching digital signal processing to a class, third year class. I'm never upset at students for the questions, in the sense, the questions that I've been always, but I was upset for a different reason with the class. I had asked them to do an assignment and which they didn't want to do, and they went and talked about this to the head of department and all that, and I was very upset that it's very interesting. I think you are all teachers. I would like to share the story with you. It's how sometimes teachers. I had asked last semester, I had asked my class to help me with. I have these recorded lectures on digital signal processing, and I said, let us this time do a different kind of assignment. When we are learning the course on digital signal processing, let us do a different kind of assignment. Let us take these lectures and see how we can embellish them. Suppose you wanted to, so you listen to the lectures, you embellish them. That is, you creatively add to the lectures to explain the ideas. This was the assignment I gave them. For some reason, towards the beginning of last January, January 2020, when I started teaching the third year class, I felt that this is something is going to be different this time. I felt that. Normally, I give them an assignment where they explore an application and make a presentation, an exhibition and presentation. Somehow, this time, I felt that may or may not happen. Something in me sort of just made me feel it may or may not happen. So I told them, this time, we must do something related to distance education, online education. And I gave them this assignment. At that time, this pandemic thing was not known, by the way. People are just talking about, in fact, I myself had hardly heard about COVID and all that at that time. It was in January. I gave them this assignment. So some part of the class was doing it, some part of the class was a little unwilling. And there was some unpleasant exchange in the class, not only about this assignment, but about some other misbehavior in the class. See, that annoys me a lot. When people are disrespectful, when students are disrespectful, when students are arrogant, that annoys me a lot. Not if somebody is taking time to understand a concept, that I'm patient. But arrogance and disrespect is something about which I get angry. So that upset me in February in the class. And then I was discussing this with the head, and head said, some people are saying that you have given this assignment and all that. And so, that time, I was very upset. I told the head, here, these people have these lectures available to them. All that is being asked is, they should embellish them. And, why they're not willing to do that? And there were some students who were refusing to do that. And interestingly, towards the end of March, everybody had to go online. I was thinking, in February, one of the students asked me a question. He said, sometimes I don't feel like doing an assignment. How should I handle that situation? I said, you should see who has given you the assignment. Is it your friend who's asking you to do his assignment when he should be doing it? Or is it your teacher who's asking you to do the assignment? If it is your teacher, then you should do the assignment. If it is your friend who's asking you to do the assignment for him, maybe you should think whether you are depriving the friend of a chance to learn. So, I was telling him, sometimes you should see from what source a command is coming and then take a decision how to deal with the command. And interestingly, towards the end of March, as all of us very well know what happened, everybody went online. That time I told the class, you know, I wrote to the class saying that now you understand what I was saying in January. You know, see, I mean, of course, you know, I must share with you, I got some very ugly feedback from the class, and I still despise, you know, in all these years of my teaching, I'm sharing this with you because of the bad side which I've seen, you know, when as a teacher, I arrogance and a lack of respect is something which I am never patient with. You know, this is something which I'm not patient with. Otherwise, I think, you know, I just wanted to share this with you because you're all teachers. I don't mind my sharing this with you. But, you know, about taking time to learn, I think, you know, that's not something about which, you know, one needs to be patient. But I feel, I don't know what you people feel. I feel arrogance should not be encouraged. But, you know, I'd like to hear views on that.
No, yes, sir. That's very true. That's very human. I mean, nobody would like. I mean, we always say, no, the other person should always be treated with respect. Yeah. Despite his profession, despite his post, everything. So respect definitely improves the relationships. That's what I think.
Yeah, that makes a difference. Yeah, so I thank you so much, Professor Atri. Are there anybody else who would like to share any thoughts? Yes.
Sir, just now you asked Dr. Prashant Atawale that whether these kind of courses should be taken ahead. So I would like to actually share my experience. I'm Manisha over here speaking on the other end. It's actually in way back in 2008, we had a workshop by Wipro, Mission 10X, who were like they wanted to train the teachers. So we did not have any technical background, but they taught us the methods, how we can implement it in our teaching. And I really felt that this is somewhere the engineering or the technical institutions are lacking, wherein we graduate from a college, or nowadays it's like post-graduation and you enter into a technical institute and you start teaching. And this is somewhere we are actually not being trained professionally to teach. And at the same time, mathematical subjects like signals and systems, DSP, I mean, dealing with these subjects, they are heavily mathematical subjects. But if you give them the right analogy, they make it very interesting to the students. And this really requires guidance from teachers like you. As Dipti ma'am had rightly said that you are the Dronacharya for this kind of subjects. And we really need these kind of guidance. So I really appreciate the kind of efforts you have really taken for this online workshop, whether it is online or offline mode, but we all need this kind of training. And it will help us to make this course more interesting, more application oriented, and it will make the students understand its importance at the same time. So this is something which I really wanted to tell you. And I really am thankful to you for giving us this opportunity to learn. And that's all, sir. This is something which I wanted to tell you from my heart. Thank you so much.
I mean, I must also, reciprocate by appreciating your active participation from day one. You know, I could see that, you know, you have very actively and enthusiastically participated right from day one.
Thank you, sir. But to be very honest, it is by looking at your enthusiasm which ignited the enthusiasm in us again.
Very nice. It's good to know. It's very nice. By the way, I must mention to you, Dr. Kalpana just told you that, you know, there's going to be a pure pedagogy workshop also in January.
Yes, I did see that. Yes.
So there's a pure pedagogy workshop by pedagogy experts. You know, I'm a signal systems from that point of view, but the pedagogy experts are also going to talk about pedagogy.
Yes, sir. And this is really interesting, actually. It makes your subject interesting. And it takes you to a completely different level of teaching, and it makes you connect with your students more. So this is really going to be helpful for teachers like us. It's really good that you all are taking this kind of initiative.
I'm really glad that you people, you know, appreciate and I'm really happy to see the kind of participation that all of you put in. That's very creditable. In fact, that makes me enthusiastic too. You know, so I was. I shared this, you know, experience with my third year class with you just now, simply to contrast how you people have participated and, you know, how sometimes, you know, see, I was telling my third year students, I said, see, you people, you know, we are doing so much, and, you know, I think sometimes you people need to see what you have here and realize what other people don't have. I sometimes feel, you know, so I don't know, sometimes, see, I think when things are available too easily, then people lose value for them. You know, I sometimes, many IIT students are actually very grateful, but I feel some IIT students are not grateful for what they have because they get it too easily. Anyways, you know, I, as teachers, I just want to share, you know, one thought with you. See, this pandemic has forced teachers and students to be separated, you know, and they, do you think that students will now better appreciate the value of, you know, in-person teaching in the future? Because, you know, they've been deprived of it for a whole semester.
Yes, sir. I do agree with you. I do agree with you very much. Yes. Last week in itself, one of my final year students told me that I'm asking, why are you not coming to the class? He was telling that somehow I don't like it. मैम कब कब हमको जाना पड़ेगा आपके कॉलेज जाना है कब तो देयर इज अनलेस एंड अंटिल यू हैव अ आई कांटेक्ट विद योर स्टूडेंट देन दिस नॉलेज ट्रांसफर बिकम्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट
यस
वेरी डिफिकल्ट सो ये दिस इज समथिंग ऑनलाइन इन ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू हैंडल हायर सेमेस्टर स्टूडेंट्स If you can handle first year students, second year students as well, but higher to handle the higher semester students, it becomes very, very difficult.
Yes, yes.
By the some of my student is doing PhD in IIT Bombay, sir.
I see.
Shayan Banerjee. Do you?
Shayan Banerjee. Yes, yes, yes. I know him.
Yes.
He's working with Professor Subhashish Chaudhary, I think, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh, no, Shayan Banerjee. He also served as a PA for my course once. Yeah.
He is from our college.
Oh, very nice. Very nice. Yes. I know him.
And well.
If you're in touch with him, tell him I remembered him. You can tell him I remembered him.
Okay. He is our alumni.
Very
nice. And our senior Professor Tapun Kumar Basu, you know him?
Yes.
I actually, I was talking. He is now adjunct professor in our college.
Okay.
So I was talking to you, talking to him regarding this course. So he was very happy to know that you are the course coordinator for us. So he told me that since you are there, the course will be very much interesting. And
that's very nice.
So I also felt that, yes, sir told me that you should do this course very attentively and you take part in it. So,
but madam,
okay, thank you very much.
We must all appreciate your tenacity and your commitment to the course. I mean, you had a very bad group with you, but you've been very tenacious in preparing the preparing the presentations and making such beautiful presentations, you know, all through the course. Very nice, very creditable.
Sir, I will suggest one thing.
Yes.
In the next course, in the part two, I have registered, and also I am very much willing to join. But I will suggest you prepare the group on the first day.
That's a good idea. I think that's a good idea.
Because who are joining and who are not joining, there are people, they will not join. So if you are in this group, if I am again in that type of group,
yes,
that will be very much difficult. So
we can reorganize the group. We can do a tentative grouping, but we should reorganize the groups on the first day.
Yes, yes.
That's a good idea. That's a very good idea. I think I'll take that idea. We should reorganize the group. We should do a tentative grouping and reorganize the groups on the first day.
That's again, yes, sir. That will be better. That will be better.
It's a very good idea. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you for participating so enthusiastically. And, you know, very nice. So,
sir, this is Namrata here.
Yes.
Sir, before I joined this workshop, I thought it will be like just like other workshop where you see, you just go through the lectures and you finish it. But I like the way it teaches the teachers how to teach the subject. So mostly the discussion was very interactive, and I got to know many things, how to deliver the subject. And especially it will be it was very helpful, mainly because we had a very experienced person sitting on the other side. So because of that, we got a lot of input, sir, mainly because of you and other good professors who are in the team. We got a lot of inputs. And as a madam said, because some of them may have other academic commitments, they could not be as per the schedule that you have planned for some, at least some schedule. So in that case, if you can make the teams initially so yes. that the others will not have to suffer being alone in the group.
No,
so that will be better, sir.
So we'll make some tentative grouping, but on the first day we can reorganize.
Yes, sir. But I got to know a lot of things about teaching this subject or this kind of subject, and it was really helpful, sir. And I'm really looking forward to other subjects also. And when there are so many workshops that is happening on the higher level subjects like machine learning and artificial intelligence, etc., but nobody is concentrating on basic foundation subjects. So this was very useful in that place where we could build up our foundation, which is very necessary being a faculty or a teacher. So it really helped us a lot, sir. It was really a good initiative from your side, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you for your kind words, and thank you for participating so enthusiastically in this workshop. Very nice.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Yeah, so any other inputs from anybody?
Very good evening, sir.
Yes, very good evening, Professor Ramachandra.
I'm very happy to interact with eminent professor from IIT Bombay. This is my first experience in my lifetime, sir. I never interact with any professor from IIT, sir. So with your permission, you gave me such an opportunity to attend this workshop, which is very helpful for me. So hereafter, I would like to change my way of teaching to grab the input from which were given to me. So I had less communication skills in English, sir. I would like to improve in that side. The way how to represent, I have to change in my future, sir.
You also participated very enthusiastically, and you know, I'm very happy to have young and enthusiastic people like you in the workshop. It's very nice. Yes. So
thank you, sir. I'm very happy, sir.
Yes, so am I. So I'm also very happy to have you in the course.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
There's a question from Professor Jayanti. Is the DSP workshop planned for other colleges? I don't see. We have announced it on
technical. No, hello.
But yeah, hello. Yeah.
Yeah, Kalpana just shared it on the this one message box, and that is available. That is available from 9th to 11th.
Yeah, it is. I think anybody
it
can.
Is, announced now. Yeah.
So I think we can make it open because it's a PPCCLT event for TechWhip people. We will come. You know, actually, it was announced as a TechWhip course, but anyway, I mean, I think anybody can register. Only thing is that we have to specify whether it is TechWhip or non-TechWhip institution.
Yeah.
So that's I think other people can also register. There's no problem, but you must say whether it's a TechWhip institution or non-TechWhip.
Yeah, yeah,
we have to count the TechWhip participants.
Right.
By the way, you know, Professor Marathe, I just want to share with you that as far as I'm concerned, because see, now we have to report that all the people from Walchand College were nominated. From our point of view, we are taking it that all of you who have participated, because see, you online, it's very difficult to check attendance and all that, right? So on the basis of your nomination, we are thinking of all of you as participants in this course.
Okay.
Is that fine?
Yeah.
Because you know, you can share the material later or whatever.
Sure.
See, because we have to keep track of the participation.
That's it.
So from our point of view, all those who were nominated have participated.
Yeah, okay, no problem.
Right?
Oh, sure.
So answer to Professor Jayanti is, you know, we will open it to non-TechWhip also. I think we'll just try. So we will, only thing is you have to specify whether it's TechWhip, non-TechWhip. We have to keep a separate record. There's no that we can do.
Any so for the it has to come on Lakshya, na?
I'll have to discuss that with Dr. Kalpana later, whether we can go down
the So right now we have not opened because only signals and systems we have advertised on Lakshya, not BSP. So we'll for non-TechWhip, if Professor Gadre wants, then we have to see how.
Lakshya, I'm not Should, can we do that on Lakshya now? Or is it too late? We can discuss it offline if you want. We can discuss
it. Yeah, we'll discuss it. Maybe tomorrow we can discuss
it. Fine, we can discuss it tomorrow. I just, you know, since we are more busy with these two workshops, we just did not plan anything for that one. So we can either we can even reschedule it. So we'll anyway, but you know, we'll discuss it offline. Yeah.
Sir?
Yes, yes.
Good evening, sir. Seema Diwan from Walton College of Engineering.
Yes.
It is very enlightening experience interacting with you.
Yes.
We got very practical application-oriented inputs, and it was very helpful in correlating the real-time applications with signals and system, which is difficult in mathematical courses. Definitely, it will help us in teaching in more improved way. So there is another request from my end.
Yes.
If any practical oriented course, for example, the applications of signal processing in stock market analysis or security analysis, or in applications in electrical engineering.
We'll have to plan that kind of a course. You know? We'll do it in the future. Now that you have suggested this, we'll do it in the future.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Hello, Ashish. Yeah, how Professor Ashish? Good to see you. Good to see your video today.
Is it okay? My video was kind of messed up.
Bandwidth issue. Yeah, right.
I don't know whether it's an appropriate to talk in on this. Is it really possible that we kind of teach the essence of signals and systems without involving much of mathematics, try to focus only on the concepts? Thank you, sir. I mean, minimum involvement of mathematics.
Yeah. I would put it the other way. I would say, when you teach signals and systems, let the students desire the maths that you're teaching them rather than feel that it is forced upon them. Teach it in such a way that the maths is what they look forward to rather than what they shun and what they keep away from. You know, very often in engineering, we try to say, oh, I don't want to bring in maths. I would say, let us as teachers aim to, let us as teachers bring in mathematics into engineering pedagogy in such a way that students desire it and enjoy it rather than wanting to keep away from it. You see what I'm saying? Because mathematics is a vehicle for proper understanding, including, you know, now you work in devices, I'm sure you appreciate that. To understand devices very well, you really need to understand the mathematical intricacies at some level. But you know, if the process is very hard, some effort has to be made. But you know, the student needs to be initiated into the beauty of it. The moment the student is initiated into the beauty, the student would himself or herself want to pursue it. So as teachers, that is what we need to do.
Yes.
More than trying to keep the student away from the maths, we must try to invite the student to the maths and immerse him or her into it. That is the way it should be.
Yeah. Yesterday I basically sent similar message to Professor Ram Gopal Rao. Okay,
yes.
He also replied in the same manner that the way maths are taught in our UG students is really pathetic. Okay, he also appreciated that something should be done, needs to be done to remove this the panicked face of the student.
I'm glad you mentioned it. One of the things that we have been doing is conducting mathematics in engineering workshops.
Yes.
Maybe I'll keep you informed of that.
Yes. So
we are under PPCC LT, under TechWhip also. Maybe we'll do that. You know, we are conducting mathematics in engineering workshops.
Yes, sir.
So we feel that, you know, signal system is one discipline, but in any engineering discipline,
yes.
How do you invite the student to we are going to conduct many such activities of mathematics in engineering.
Yes.
Under TechWhip and even afterwards.
Yes.
So in on different platforms in IIT. So I'm glad you raised that. I thought I should mention this to all the participants.
Yes, sir. I think if you take such initiative, it will be a great.
We have already done a little bit of it. Now we'll do more of it. Now that you also appreciate its importance, I think we'll do more of it.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you for coming. Thank you for participating. It's good to have senior people like you participate and, you know, from the NITs, because that gives us a feeling that we are reaching out to many people. Very good. Very nice.
Yes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you for participating.
Sir, I have one point here.
Yes. Yes.
Sir,
yes.
In our syllabus, we have all the four Fourier representations like CTFS, CTFT, DTFS and DTFT.
Yes.
So, and we generally club it like either all continuous in one unit and all discrete in one unit, or all Fourier series in one unit or Fourier transform in one unit. Then what happens is we have two full units, and in all these we have to teach them the definition and then the properties and problems with the properties. So it is kind of monotonous, and the students also feel bored when we talk the same thing again and again, but yes. They are different. And yeah. If we don't teach them, they get confused. Even if we teach them, they get confused with all this. Good. So how do we deal with this?
Yes. So I can see Professor Somani has also raised his hand. I'll come to you, Professor Somani. I'll just answer this question. See, I would answer the question like this. A little bit of repetition is okay. But the repetition, as you said, must be conscious of the need for repetition. That is, some concept we think they are being repeated. Actually, you know, it's not necessary that by being repeated, the concept is seen the same way. Very often, the same idea, when discussed again in a different context, brings up new interpretations. So when we repeat, if the same idea is brought up in different contexts, it's also important to show different faces of the idea. Because, you know, the same idea may have many different interpretations, like in, as you said, you know, the Fourier series, Fourier transform, these in different situations, some of the interpretations can be different. So, you know, to bring up the richness of interpretations possible is one of the ways of getting around this problem of monotony.
Okay, sir. And maybe we can have a comparison of the properties with
comparison.
All this.
Yeah, that's also. So, you know, bringing up different interpretations, different facets, that brings a richness.
Okay.
Yes, Professor Somani.
Sir, good evening, sir.
Very good evening.
I think actually whatever this mathematics, the main issue is in mathematics. I think actually whatever it has been taught up to 12th and then in the first year, this mathematics has been taught by the mathematician. That is actually the crux, mathematician and Fourier series they have been taught in first year, Fourier series they have done in 12th standard also, right? But when it has been applied to this applied subject, actually that interpretation that is actually missing. And actually there is a debate of this particular thing that who should be taught the mathematics for electronics engineering or mathematics for that whatever the engineering they are. And there is always a debate in the science faculty and engineering faculty, like we all are teacher, right? So actually that whatever the load calculation is there, in that particular load calculation, they have to be given. Otherwise, if one faculty from the electronics has been actually spared for that, that is the major in our BOS also, we are discussing this. We have to see, balance the things. But the problem is like that whatever the mathematics teacher will be there, that has to be having that some inclination towards that application in the different discipline. That has been done at the start, actually it is very easy for the students to learn mathematics or the subject, mathematical subject. Otherwise that name itself is a M1, M2. It is M1, but it is read as an M.
This is a good joke, you know. I'm not sharing it with others, with your permission.
This is the dreaded things has been happening.
Yes. In fact, you know, I'll share with you, many of the IIT students also dread this MA course, you know. They say, my goodness, this MA course, you know, because then you write the epsilon delta and so on. That's what I'm saying. Actually, students, when they come into engineering, many of them are fond of mathematics. They enjoy mathematics.
Correct,
when they come into engineering, they suddenly see a draconian phase, as you said, you know, the Yama phase of mathematics.
Yes.
It's a pity, actually. Yamadev is also quite kind at some point.
Yeah.
You should show the kinder face of the, you know, Yamadev.
Now, the other end of the thing is like taken MATLAB. It is a matrix laboratory. So, whatever the base that is a background is a totally mathematics.
Yeah.
Right? Totally mathematics. And how, when they realize.
Yeah, the problem, the whole difficulty comes, I'll share with you, you know, without taking any names. One typical attitude I see, as you mentioned, of some people who are in the mathematics domain is, well, we do the maths and applications are left to others. This is a view taken by them.
Yes.
That's not necessarily a very conducive view to teaching maths.
Correct.
You know, I feel that people who are working in the mathematics domain sometimes need to think, well, you know, how can I apply this in other disciplines? How is this useful to other disciplines? And they should not see, one thing is I may not know, then I can always go and ask. But some people are unwilling to do it. That is a pity.
Correct.
Unwillingness can be a pity. Unwillingness can be a problem. So at least the willingness, you know,
If they have shown that particular thing, the math becomes pleasurable otherwise.
Yes, it is a pleasure.
And it will be having everything mathematics in every subject of a mathematical subject or any modeling, whatever we do, it is you require mathematics.
Mathematics. So, to appreciate the model well.
Yeah, that is a very important one. And signals and systems is the first subject, like you mentioned, that ubiquitous.
Yes.
Subject for all discipline, all the domain, all the discipline. Because without any signal, actually what is input for any system is a signal.
True.
Right? And if you understand that particular thing, that will give you the better understanding in their application subject also.
Yes.
So that is a very important thing. So I think actually you have been shown the pathways to this. Actually, I am in the application layer. But now, actually, I have done with the physical layer also in this pedagogy as well as the understanding the signal and system. So, and your way of a teaching as well as that, again, the many participants has pointed out that you are always a smiling face, always smiling face. And that smile is nothing but your actual signature, which is giving you everybody to understand the things in better way. So, and your patience, that is a very important thing that and the way of teaching naturally your lot many courses are there, lot many things are there, which is good. And I enjoyed this workshop. I think I have attended 100% this workshop, 100% this workshop.
That is true. We must appreciate the past. Yes.
Yeah. And
record our appreciation for your participation. As you said, you know, you've been there right from the first day until these last few moments of the workshop, and very, very enthusiastic. And you brought before the audience some very, very useful pointers and some very useful thoughts. So we really appreciate this kind of enthusiastic participation.
I believe, like, actually, suppose I'm not understanding, suppose, but if you are there in the class because of the discussion and because of that, whatever delivery has been done, actually, you will get understood. That is the very important thing, and that's why the attendance is must for this particular workshop. Whenever you are attending any workshop, so you attend 100%. So otherwise, actually, don't apply or don't sign up for that particular thing, because you have to take away 100% out of that. That is how much you explore. That totally means that how much you have attended attentively. That is very important. So. I have been interaction with the things, but sir, can we have this total group, because we are having now the member of five, that is a group five, group six, and out of that only three are
Dr. Kalpana, is it possible for us to let the participants interact with one another entirely? Is that within the framework that we operate
on IIT Bombay X? Urmila, can we have a cohort or a group made with so the same group you they want to
involve. What you're saying is now they are only that 2-3 people there. All the people who are in this workshop, make a group of them.
That will be better to actually interact
this thing will be, we can keep it open for a longer time.
They can also post it on discussion forum. They can use the course discussion forum to interact with the other colleagues.
Right. No, I think what they're also saying is, can they get in touch with one another? Is that right?
Yes, sir.
So is there a way they can be permitted to get in? So can, in that case, then you can put it on the discussion forum, and all those who want can put up their contact information.
Yes. So a discussion can happen on discussion forum. We can make this course live for maybe one more month or I don't know.
Let's do that. Let's keep the course live for a month so that you can have discussion on the discussion forum, and you can share your contact information.
Yeah, that way, the indirect way to get the contacts.
Will that be fine?
If they want, then everybody has to agree. If they don't mind sharing their email and phone number, then we will make that thing available. We can send it by email, but then everybody has to agree because privacy.
Okay.
So what we can do is, or we can say those who agree, we can make it public. Is it? That is a possibility.
Yeah.
Yes.
All of you who agree to make your contact information public to the participants only, not to everybody, then we can make it public, isn't it?
Yeah, because we can correlate these things, right? Because
can we do one thing? So, yeah. Dr. Kalpana, let us keep the course live for a month. Is that possible?
Yeah. So that we'll keep it.
That, but what I can say is in the discussion forum, those participants who would like to share their contact information can, isn't it? So
So
in fact, Dr. Somani, what you can do is you can initiate in the discussion forum. You can say that I would like to share and I would like people to contact me, and you can share your contact information, and then invite other people also to do the same.
Not a problem.
Yes, Professor Sanyal, thank you so much. I know she's saying that she has to leave. Thank you so much for coming.
Yeah. So we will keep it till January, 1st of January.
Even mid-January is fine.
Yes, thank you, sir.
So in fact, you can initiate on the discussion forum saying that you would like to share your contact information, and you invite others also to do the same. So we can keep the course live until mid-January. Yeah, very nice. Very nice. So any other? So then, very good. So I think anything else? Anybody else would like to come forward, or should we then conclude now? I think we can conclude. So anybody else would like to come forward? All right. So. The question is, how long the lecture videos will be there forever?
Yes.
It will be available to you forever.
Even if the course ends, now tentatively we'll keep it open till January 15th. But even after the course ends, only you will not be able to attempt the quizzes or use the discussion forum. But all the lectures will be available on your dashboard.
Right.
Sir, is it whatever the discussions, whatever interactions we have done, so these videos will be also available?
Yeah, they'll be uploaded. I'll just ask Sushant, how will it be done? They're going to be edited.
So we will provide the link on the course itself.
Recording
will be also available on the course.
Okay.
It will be in the course. So it will be a part of the course. Yes. It'll be in the same course, no?
Same course. You all have registered in the thing, so it will be you can view it once we give the link.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Anybody else? Okay, then I think we should now conclude with again. I would like to conclude with our ancient words. So, sahanavavatu, sahanau bhunaktu, sahaviryam karavavahai, tejasvinavadhitamastu, ma vidvishavahai. sahanavavatu, sahan, you know, let us, you know, let us read together, let us study together. Sahanavavatu, sahanau bhunaktu, let us nourish one another. Saha viryam karavavahai, let us do great things together. Tejasvinau adhizamastu, let us, with a lot of energy and enthusiasm, let us read and study together. And let us pursue. And ma vidvishavahai, let us not, let there not be hatred or dissension. With these words, I would like to conclude this course. Thank you so much. And I look forward to, and keep your associations alive in future as well.